Hey everyone, it's Erica, and I just got back from the Wyman Estate Greenhouse sale. So, this is it. Let me unravel this. Okay, so I got a few plants, and let me just try to pull them out. Let's start with this one in the front. Okay, so this is a succulent. You can see the little pink leaf on the leaves. It's really pretty, it's variegated. So it's a really tall plant, and I think in the spring or summer when it gets warmer, I'm gonna cut it at this node here and try to root that so it looks a little nicer. And then at the bottom, there's two baby ones here. And so this is Senecio articulatus variegatus cannel plant. I thought it was very unique, so I got it. It's very, I'm attracted to the pink leaves. Okay, next on the list, let me see. This is red peanut cactus, Echinopsis chemisiris. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce these Latin names. I'm really bad at it. So it's peanut cactus. I've seen pictures online where they're in flower and they look completely covered and amazing. The flowers are like bigger than the plant and it's really pretty, so I wanted to give this a try. So I will need to research and see how to get this to flower. So if you guys know, please leave a comment and let me know. So that's the next one. Okay, and I think the rest are orchids. So let's see, this first one. Dendrobium Melody Winter Wine. So this was in the discounted orchid section, out of bloom orchids, which is kind of weird because there were other orchids out of bloom that were not discounted. So $22 originally, $11 on sale. And there's three canes. Cut spike, so it's definitely blooming size. And yeah, it looks very healthy. So that's a Dendrobium phalaenopsis, and it should be a very deep, like red wine color, like the name indicates. But yeah, I think I have another Dendrobium phalaenopsis, kind of a similar wine color. And I think that those canes are a little shorter than this, so it's not as big as this, but yeah, discounted to $11. Couldn't resist. And let's see. So this is Pottinera Dick Smith Dark Beauty Dark Splash. I'm not sure why it says Dark Beauty and Dark Splash, because I think those are two different varieties. Maybe, could it be possibly a cross? I don't see the X, but yeah. I've never had a Pottinera before, but since I recently got a Cattleya to bloom, I am going to give this a try. So there's a lot of pseudobulbs. It's supposed to be a compact plant. I think it's probably, this is probably as large as it's gonna get. And there's one new growth, two new growth. And my dog just knocked the camera. Hopefully it steadies. Yeah, $24. So I will need to repot this probably, and there's different color bark. I don't think this is pearlite. This is probably like the, I forgot what it's called. It's not pumice, but some sort of growstone, or I will need to look up the name. I forgot the name. And last plant is a very common, popular plant. Look at the pretty flowers. I don't know why, but I think a lot of my plants are this, our orchids are this color. I need to find other colored flowers. But this is a Dendrobium canyonum, and look how pretty it is. And look, one more spike, two spike, three spike, four spike, five spike, six spike, seven spike, eight spike, and not including the one flower. That's nine total. So I wasn't even gonna get this, but look how big the plant is, and then how many spikes. So here's the tag. It's Dendrobium canyonum variety madame, and the only thing wrong with this might be this leaf. I think the discoloration is probably okay, but the darker spots kind of worried me. So like the purple is probably from highlight down here, but this leaf I think I'm gonna take off, because yeah, I don't know what that is. So that's it for the plants. And then the last thing I got is a Neophenetia falcata orchid pot. So this is a specialty pot for the Neophenetia falcata orchids, and the Japanese people, or the traditional Japanese way to pot the Neophenetia falcatas is to put like a mound of moss. And so these pots are fairly uncommon. You'll have to buy them at like a specialty orchid store, or you know, some sort of greenhouse. But these are the cheap ones. $10 for a small pot is not cheap, but considering, you know, you can buy the handmade fancy painted ones for hundreds and even thousands of dollars, this is very cheap. So $10 for this pot. And I also got one previously. This is from a previous purchase at the same greenhouse. This one's a little taller pot, and I have a Neophenetia falcata in it. It's actually not potted in the pot yet. It's in a little net basket. Oops. I just pulled the whole thing out. But yeah, it needs good drainage and air, because it's all sphagnum moss. Use long fiber sphagnum moss and make this mound, and actually the core of it should be empty or hollow. So it's not actually a big ball. And so that's it for my haul today. So here are all my plants together, and I thought, since you know, I'm worried about this leaf, why don't I just snip it off now? So let me try to do this with one hand. So I have sharp pair pruners, and there goes the leaf. Yeah, so hopefully there's no problems with the plant, but all the other leaves look very healthy. And yep. Thanks for watching.